I guess Magnus, we just want to talk about tonight. I don't know what Cliff wants to say, but
just want to recap, and if there's anything that stuck out to you that you want to talk about.
One of the things that I'm having a hard time wrapping my head around, or like it hasn't really, just the reality of like Lenny's situation.
Okay. Yeah. Like, yeah, it was really hard meeting Letty today and learning about her life.
My name is Legan Saidi. I am 12 years older. Hey.
Vision for Mary's meals is that that every child in the world should be able to receive at least one good meal every day in their place of education. And we believe that's possible in this world of plenty.
Simplicity is feeding children in schools. What is there more simple? Every woman, every man knows that a child needs food. Without food, can do nothing.
The concept of Mary's Meals, we deliver food in the context of education.
The idea of Mary's Meals can change the world.
Just food. Good food in schools.
Working in the world's poorest communities, so often the poorest children can't go to school because they're working, because they're begging on street corners. They're just doing whatever it takes to put the next meal on the table. And therefore they miss out on their education, which is the key to lifting the world's poorest communities out of poverty. In India, we're working in communities where there are very particular obstacles around education.
And in India, the poorest of the poor cannot go to formal schools.
The girls in communities like the ones where we provide Mary's meals normally never go to school.
मतलब कहते हैं ना बेशक हम आजाद देश में रह रहे हैं औरत लोग आजाद देश में रहे हैं आजादी मिली हुई है
either in the slums or in the rural villages the girls are treated as second class children because education of girl children is considered to be useless
भेदभाव जो है वो नहीं होना चाहिए जितना लड़के को मानते हैं उतना ही लड़की को भी मानना चाहिए
आज के उसमें लड़कियों को अच्छा नहीं माना जाता
इसीलिए लड़कियां थोड़ा स्कूल में कम है जितने भी स्कूल हैं डांसने के अंदर सभी में कम है
माँ बाप को होनी चाहिए ना फिर पढ़ाने की तो गरीब है इस वजह से ना बिठाए
Families who traditionally didn't send their daughters to school are now sending them to school because they know they will be able to eat.
Before Mary's Meals came, we had a lot of problems. There were a lot of dropouts.
They were not coming to school. They drop out of the school because they were eating nothing when coming from home.
A lot of learners were complaining, I'm sick, I'm having stomachache, I'm having headache. It was due to hunger. Maybe because their stomachs were empty.
The teachers could not impart knowledge to the learners in the manner that it ought to be, because the learners were hungry anyway. So if you are talking to a hungry person, you can as well forget that you are talking to anyone.
Among famine, mimba mango kuti ga mango banga kabina nseru nkumada ndolana za ya kujayo. Eni maganize for school yo ndi abwino. Imato kubeze sucks of goes into zabwino. Uchifuwa ya kisu uje nchiro kufuna kusaga suit vura wibeza ifuwa ya mafisarifikida wa menu ulinamu. nini mafuna nitazata ujinesi.
Is for these children. I think the immediate thing for these children is surviving. Like, they have to think about the next day. They have to think about whether they'll make it. So hope for them is tomorrow. Will tomorrow happen for me?
And it's really hard. I find it really hard to take it in when you're talking to a child like Letty, and just when she speaks about things like being hungry, and it's hard to really think what that must be like, or it's really hard to even pretend you can imagine what it's like to be 12 years old and head of your family. You know, I've got kids at that exact same age as at home, you know, and you can't help but make the comparison with their lives, or even a comparison with Charlie, that amazing boy in England who does a lot of fundraising for Mary's Meals.
First found out about Mary's Meals in Bosnia, and I was 7 years old at the time, and on the video it said how little it cost to feed a child for a year, and I was just amazed by that. I thought it was extraordinary. My biggest event, I cycled 603 miles from Brighton to Glasgow with just my mum. 2 days before Christmas, I got 24 people together to swim 1.5 marathons. That's about 40 miles. Put yourself in their position, and imagine how they would feel, or how you would feel if you were where they are now. It's just horrible to think that they're suffering, and that could have easily been us. It could have been anyone, any one of us. Anyone watching this now, it could have been anyone.
It's very different, the commitment of the heart than the commitment of just the pocket, because we have people who have very little money, so to speak, who give, and we have those who have much more who give, and they have the same value.
How is it?
Brilliant.
It doesn't have to be a huge thing. It's the many, many little acts of love that Magnus always speaks about that make this beautiful work.
All the time I think how privileged we are to have all this. They sleep on the floor, look up at the stars, and that they don't have food, drink, shelter, nothing to keep them safe or warm at night. Just the cost is so low that even a 12-year-old like me could make such a difference. And the difference is unbelievable.
I think we all can do so much, and we have one life, and we have this world, and why not make it better? We're such a simple thing, you know?
Every child should have a daily meal, and if everyone just gave that tiny amount, that goal could be achieved so easily.
I was actually having a pint of beer with my brother one evening in our local pub, and we were talking about this news bulletin that we'd seen, which described the suffering in Bosnia at that time. Over the next 10 years, we began getting involved in all kinds of different places, from Romania to Latin America to West Africa. And it was only 10 years after we got involved in this kind of work that the Mary's Meals campaign was born. Thousands of children have died of starvation today, and millions of children are out of school because of poverty. And that I think that's crazy. I think that's insane. Decided to stay rooted here in this shed that I borrowed off my father.
He thought he might do it for a year, but it increased and increased and increased. Wherever he goes, doors seem to just open and open.
But although we live in the middle of nowhere, seems to have brought the whole world here.
You actually went and saw Magnus at his home, didn't you?
Yeah, I did.
Tell me about that.
I chased him down. We'd swapped a couple of phone calls and I said, okay, I'm coming to visit you. So I went and spent the day with him and his family and saw his charity and all the people that worked for him. That is such a worthy cause because they feed, it's now more than 500,000 children every day all over the world.
One of the reasons why we like working with RAB so much is that we have a really strong commitment to buying food locally, in country, wherever we work, so that we help the local farmer, we help the local economy.
As a matter of fact, almost all the raw materials, except the vitamins and mineral premixes, which comes from South Africa, is all locally produced. The corn and soya, we actually buy from the smallholder farmers. When we say smallholder farmers, they are really peasant farmers, having a land average landholding capacity of half an acre. At least minimum from 15 to 20,000 farmers' households are getting affected. It's much better to purchase the locally produced product than importing a product. And at the same time, indirectly, it is helping the economy one way or other.
It is part of the philosophy that the community should own part of the processes. The reason is simple. We don't want to portray them as helpless. We also want to make them empowered to take part in the processes.
We had a chance to go through some streets in Eldoret, whereby quite a number of children are living.
Sio mzuri, baridi na tuchapa, njaa, unaweza hata ukikilala njaa.
Baba alinitoroka nikiwa mdogo akaniacha na mama. Mama akaanzanga kunywa pombe akakufa.
Children at these dump sites are exposed to so many things that I've stated earlier, which end up being actually very, very chronic. You find them with wounds which never heals that fast because of they are not well protected, they are not well taken care of. At this dump site with full of chemicals and debris from factories, they will get diseases. Some of these diseases get even chronic, some even can result to death. So I would say this area is not indeed a good environment for these children. We will be seeing lots of them sniffing glue, of which I know has a lot of effects for the young child. This drug abuse has resulted to many of them getting brain damage. They're really hungry, so they sniff all this and don't feel anything.
Natoka Kibera. Nilidandia Role, nikafika mpaka huko.
Uko na miaka ngapi saa hizi?
11.
Where they used to live with the mom, the uncles, the relatives came and sold the land, and then they kicked him out, told him to go and just go and sort himself out there. So that's why he's on the streets. He has nobody so far right now to take care of him.
Tembea kwa vitamu, nikuwa kidema mzuri, nisome, nikia mkubwa nipate kazi.
When Mel's Mills came in, there was a research that we people on the ground carried out, and we recognized the most vulnerable places. We did, and we found this region. There was a need, because street children normally, they tend only just to work for food.
How many of you feel that if there will be no food in school, you will go to the street?
Because they don't have enough food at their homes, they are able to come to school and then get the basic education which they require.
Vile nilikuwa nikiendanga street, nilikuwa nikikosanga nyumbani chakula, lakini vile shule walileta chakula, ndio tukafurahia mpaka tunakujanga shule.
If the feeding program can be given to students, such that students get food, we shall not have children in the streets.
It's amazing again just to see the impact one meal has. And the people who are at the forefront of that are the people who make huge sacrifices to get up early at first light, to cook the fires, to make the porridge, to serve the food. You know, in Malawi alone there are 65,000 volunteers who are taking part in this work.
The main beneficiary is the child, and this child comes from their villages.
People like Angela and India, who make big sacrifices to go and do the work that they do so that girls in India can start coming to school.
Mary's Meals is a project which brings together children of different faith, animators of different faith, delivery partners of different faith. It has got a classical or a lasting purpose and effect and dream that has to be fulfilled. We are trying to give hope to the children in India.
It creates joy. It generates community work. It generates collaboration together. This simple meal brings hope.
Or whether it be Charles or Abel, who are you know, pulling those kids off the streets, who are changing their lives. For me, one of the really important things about Mary's Meals is that this isn't about, you know, a bunch of rich people from the West charging in and solving everyone's problems in Africa or India or wherever. It's a whole lot of us around the world walking together with the same very simple goal, that the hungry child receives a meal every day.
Mary's Meals helps in this very simple way, that it allows volunteers, mothers, to cook their own food for their own children in their own schools. It's a motherly, simple act. Does something mothers want to do, but if they can't, we have to do it.
Most of us go through life wondering if we could help, but not really feeling that we can help. And if you get involved in something like this, you immediately help.
It's about a child. It's not about the big numbers, and it's also about the next child. It's about the next child that's waiting for Mary's meals.